Hey, what's up guys, TotallyDubbed here, and today I'm doing a video review on the BenQ ZOWIE XL2720. Now this is a full HD 144Hz monitor. Now before getting into the specs, in terms of pricing, this can be found for a pretty expensive £370 on Amazon.co.uk. On Amazon USA, it's a much more sensible $371. Now in terms of the specs, it's a 27-inch monitor that has aspect ratio of 16:9. It's full HD, so 1920x1080. It runs at 144Hz, and you'll need a display port, or you can run it via DVI. It is a TN panel, so I'll get into that in just a bit, with a quoted response time of 1 millisecond. In terms of inputs, you have display ports, you've got two HDMIs, you've got DVI, and you've got VGA if you so wish. You've also got a headphone jack if you'd like to use it. You've also got a USB 3.0 hub, which can be used for you to connect up devices or to charge your smartphone. Now there's no speaker on the monitor itself, however you can feed a signal to it and output it via your headphone jack, which can be found on the monitor itself. Now let's move on to the build quality. If you're interested in specs, I'll link them down in description below. Now in terms of the actual build quality, I'm very much impressed with what BenQ have done here. The monitor is very adjustable, it goes up and down, tilts backwards and forward, and does a full 180 if you so wish. The stand itself is made out of plastic, it doesn't look too appealing, but it is quite minimal. It looks quite minimal on your desk and blends in very well. What I like is that you also got this little switch device, which is useful for accessing the OSD. Better still, this can be attached via magnets on the side of your stand, which makes it blend in very well, and it's quite a nice design, just generally speaking. The bezels of the monitor are not my favourite, they're quite chunky, therefore the panel seems to be a little bit inside the bezels, where it could have been a little bit more forwards. Nevertheless, the bezels themselves are not too distracting, even though they're chunky, but they've got a kind of a greyish black tone to them, and it's a matte colour. Now, in terms of the monitor's OSD, they can be accessed by this little control pod or via the touchscreen buttons on the side. Now, I'm not a massive fan of touchscreen buttons, but I must say BenQ have done a fantastic job in terms of the touch sensitivity. Also, the fact that these lights illuminate and the fact that you can customize what is appeared over here as the quick menu is a good addition. Now, let's just quickly go into that in terms of the OSD. So, just to show you the settings that you get, just reduce the EV of my camera. Now, in terms of the OSD, hopefully you can see that. There we go, and just zoom in just a little bit more. You've got a huge amount of options over here. Now, in terms of the picture, I've got it on brightness 100, contrast 50, low blue light mode, blur reduction, color temperature. I've gone user mode. Now, I've gone for 97 on R, G on 99, and B on 100. That's what I felt gave me the most accurate colors to my eyes. I've got AMA, which is on premium, and I'll get into that in just a bit. I've got instant mode enabled, and sharpness on 5, and gamma on 3. In terms of the picture advanced, you've got picture modes, you've got different picture modes you can select from, there's a huge amount of selection there. Overscan off, display mode on full, smart focus I haven't gone into. You can save the settings, and as I said, you can go into different settings that you can customize with different gamer profiles. Audio settings, as I mentioned, it's audio that can be bypassed through your 3.5mm jack. I have turned off the buzzer, but you've got a little buzzer sound if you so wish to use it. That's how it sounds, which is quite distracting to me, but can be useful in terms of audio cues. And in terms of the system itself, you can see that you've got the OSD settings, the custom keys that you can customize, switch, and also in terms of the general information of the monitor, so it's running at 144Hz right now. It hasn't got AMD FreeSync or Nvidia G-Sync, at least from what I can tell, so do bear that in mind if you're going to be looking to buy the monitor and you have a compatible graphics card with it. So, build quality aside, how is the actual panel quality itself? Now, despite having a TN panel, I think it's one of the better, if not one of the best TN panels I've seen at 144Hz. It is very impressive at how good this monitor is. for its color accuracy and its just general way it can portray images. It's very, very accurate, and I must say, like for example over here, the deep blacks appear very well and the white point is quite well done. There's a little bit of a color shift if you start moving left and right, but it's very minimal. Given the fact it's a TN panel, that is to be expected, but that said, as its size is, well, not relatively small, but due to its size, you're not going to be really looking away left and right and noticing a massive shift in colours when you're sitting down. Now, in terms of the actual colour accuracy over here, it's beautiful, the colours really do pop. They could pop a little bit more, I mean, it doesn't quite compete with a IPS or PLS panel, but it is absolutely beautiful. Over here, you've got the greens, which really do appear to be popping and quite bright. Over here again you've got very nice a very nice scenic shot which really does appear very nicely. I must say I'm very impressed with this panel. The TN panel usually is not my favorite because of just how it looks, because everything looks washed out, but BenQ have done a fantastic job here in terms of providing a very good TN panel. So I must say, if you're looking for picture quality, you can definitely get it through this. It won't compete with an IPS or PLS panel just due to the technology that's used within it, but it does come very, very close in providing those deep reach colors with a fantastic contrast ratio. So very impressed with BenQ in that. But most importantly, how does it perform when it comes to gaming? So I play Counter-Strike on a daily basis, and I must say this monitor is fantastic. It's fully responsive, it's got very low input lag, at least to my perceived gaming, and I must say it just is fantastic. Now I've got AMA on premium, as you probably noted before, and you will probably notice here there is very minimal ghosting. Now when I looked very closely, there is a slight overshoot ghosting that occurs on sort of jagged edges or on the corners of walls, but it is very minimal. When I turn down the AMA to off or a medium, I do notice a lack of response. However, why would you do that when you've got premium AMA, which runs with barely any sort of overshoot ghosting, and more so just performs fantastic in terms of the responsiveness of the monitor? So yes, the monitor is responsive, it works fantastically, and the input lag is relatively low. I didn't have any sort of problems moving around and using the monitor on a daily basis, and I know rip chickens. So yes, would I use this as a gaming monitor? Absolutely, I would use it as a competitive gaming monitor as well. I would definitely see myself playing Counter-Strike on this, and of course you're limited to 1080p, but you know, most competitive gamers are not going to be playing above 1080p nevertheless, even though I do, but I mean that's just a bit different. That's because I quite like looking at a 1440p display. So honestly, overall guys, it's fantastic in terms of its gaming performance. Competitive gamers, casual gamers will all rejoice of how good the monitor is, and I must say, no complaints whatsoever gaming wise. So overall, what do I think of the monitor? Well, I think it's a fantastic monitor. It is expensive, don't get me wrong, and when I compare it to other monitors out there, for example, an AOC 27-inch 144Hz monitor that also runs on a TN panel, this is £280, whereas the BenQ is £370. So it is a lot of difference in terms of price. However, that premium that you're paying, you really do get it out in terms of the color accuracy and the overall almost IPS-like image quality. So it is a little bit of premium, and I do appreciate that most people will think 1080p, £370 just seems ridiculous to pay that, especially like, for example, you've got a Samsung curved 24-inch 144Hz monitor that also is around £300. So, you know, what's the logic behind buying this type of monitor? Well, it does a lot right. There's very little that it does wrong. The only thing that it really does wrong is its price. So if you can find it for cheaper, jump at it. It's a fantastic monitor. At £370, I can't see myself recommending it, but can still praise the monitor for actually being good itself. So there we go, guys. Up to you to make your own decisions if you want to buy it or not. Check in the links in the description below if you are interested in buying it, or feel free to check out the AOC monitor that I mentioned, and also the Samsung monitor that I mentioned, also in the links in the description below with my reviews with it. Alright guys, I've been TotallyDubbed. Make sure you like, comment and subscribe, favorite and share this video as it always helps, and let me know in the comments below what you think of the monitor, if you own it or something that you'd be looking at. Alright guys, TotallyDubbed out. Bye bye.